My name is Ransony, and welcome back to video games. Specifically, this one's Darkest Dungeon 2. Wow, my voice is very loud in my own ears right now. How do I turn that down? Duh? Hey! Excellent. Alright, so we're off to the Tangle.
War. Rewards only. Resignation.
Getting a little bit of the map revelation onto ourselves. There's a couple paths at the end there that have heavy loathing, so I should try and make sure that I don't end up with more than four. A hospital over onto the left side. If I keep the flame above 40, I can get a mastery by the end of this. Gotta enter the scroll, use a pouch of lie. This is our final region, so neither of those is really gonna be occurring. So we do have all of the ridiculous extra health on our flagellant. How's our money? Oh, yikes. We've only got six relics, which means this early hospital is very unlikely to be particularly useful for us. If I could take out this Oblivion's Ingress, getting mastery, getting trinkets, obviously reduction of loathing, but also if I came to that from the other resistance encounter, which, yeah, it's a fight after a fight after a fight, and there's, you know, barricades in the combat spaces in between as well, but that will give me a lot of flexibility to take whatever route I want at the very end by knocking down all of the loathing I would otherwise be gaining. Yeah, if I want to have the possibility of going anywhere except for the hospital, I have to go to the right, so we'll be going to the right to begin with. Blooding Craw, Misstep from the Dark Impulse, Price of Pride, and Befuddling Sundial. At turn start, this is occurring. Interesting. Alright. Let's go into the unknown. I actually could have seen from where I was standing what was in the unknown. Specifically, I could have seen that was Wheels check. Interesting. So maybe there's a little bit of visual scouting that we're going to have to do in the future as well.
They revel in debauchery. Debasing themselves in the face of the end.
Interesting. We're going to avoid making friends by taking fights here. Let's think about this for a second. If this isn't loathing and this isn't loathing, if neither of those paths give us loathing, then I don't need to take this fight. However, I would also like the resources from this fight. And I tend to end up at the end of the fight, better off than when I went in. Right, of course. Got these two big guys over the back line, the bishops, both with benediction. One of them has two stacks, one of them has only one. Their blight resist is 30%. We crit one of them, so pretty likely to have managed to hit the blight on that target. Also got the blight on the other target as well. Love it. I'm looking for some sky-slapping action here. 5 to 9 was the damage range. We rolled 5 on both of them. Got the glimmer of light, glimmer of hope, rather, to keep the torch high. Let's have a look at the knight's most painful abilities.
Let's take a closer look at the thing, as repulsive as it is.
So, Biting Blade. Interestingly, I think I do want Biting Blade to try and target John, because John does have the ability to resist that very effectively with Dark Impulse. When damaged, 15% chance to become blinded. Oof. So I could try and bellow at the enemies, give myself speed over them in the next round. I could also roll Stand Fast relatively earlier on here. I don't want to take every turn as seriously as this.
Observe the subject carefully, and you will discover its weaknesses.
But certainly I want to take... as many precautions as I can with my opening here. I'm gonna bellow.
Cunning. You may outwit them yet.
So we managed to debuff both of their backliners. Also hit a debuff on ourselves. Cannot gain dodge. Fair enough. Definitely going to be running Harvest here. I want to throw some Crow's Feet, but again, that is my serrated item, so I can only throw a total of one of them, and this situation is not dire enough for that. Bleed could have been a lot worse there.
malaise, measured and steady.
Very nice. So we've already got the kill now, and I'm going to use the demon's pull to pull the other out of position. Both of them will die as soon as they reach their turn. Oh, interesting. Unfortunately, that unit just picked up on guard. That is to say, they now have the ability to riposte, and I don't have my bellow ready to be able to stop them from riposting. I'm going to use Stand Fast, because Barrison is our last unit to act this round. Then both of the enemies will die, and hopefully I'll have the ability to bellow at this Guardian relatively early on. Now, you don't do anything with corpses, do you? No. However, you wouldn't have the ability to use Habit You if there were no corpses. That doesn't seem almost at all important. So, riposte says counterattacks the next damaging attack, which means that I should, by all rights... Oh. Actually, hang on, maybe I stun you. If I use Abyssal Artillery here, I do have two stacks of power on myself. Killed the corpse, 34 damage. Also didn't manage to stun the target, unfortunately. Rude. I legitimately believe that I should probably heal John preemptively. Harvest or Slice Off? Harvest, unfortunately, only hits this one target once. Yes, it's pretty important I start getting DOTs on that guy. Yeah, maybe I should have... There's no real recovery actions everyone else could have just taken for the rest of the round while we waited there. Heck, with the combos on enemy targets, maybe Rampart would actually be pretty good here. I tend to get combo on them quite often. I'm gonna defend our other frontliner there. Rather be taking 25% of this damage than all of it. Roll a weird reconstruction for 30 health there. Love a good 30 health heal. If I had the ability to delay my action, I would. But I don't, so I won't. Guess I'm just gonna hit you and heal up a little bit. Yeah, we've completely got this guy locked down. He's got a huge amount of bleed on our frontliner, but other than that, completely locked down. You know, Endure has a chance to remove all of the battlefield effect right now. Chop. Eh, never mind, it just put two on the flagellant, but it still got one off of Marms. Excellent. I was very much hoping to use Deathless here. Excellent. You're going down to the Death's Door. A weird reconstruction for only two health on our flagellant. Yeah, you have to expect that from time to time. Again, none of these really seem like they're going to make that much of a difference. Bellow at the enemy, try and reduce their speed. Ooh, good biting blade. Real 5 damage out of that. Oh, very scared. This guy's got high deathblow resist. I wasn't expecting to kill him with the first strike.
We are the flame, burning brightly for all the world to see.
Okay, yeah, my characters aren't great on health after that. And also, yeah, unfortunately, because we don't have 100% wheels, I'm not going to get extra road healing. I'd really like extra road healing. Ooh, some nice bread. Oh, my wheels! No! That's going to be pretty restrictive to our paths in the future now. I can't take two more paths that attack the wheels.
Emptiness and dissolution have wormed their way into the world.
So the worst relationship is Jazzy with these other two characters? I say worst, and yet it's an 18 and a 20. However, I didn't really form a friendship with either of them. Sorry. Alas. Yeah, I need to prioritize the heralds and Alter going down. Ritty, clear, top. Oi! How'd you manage to bleed him? He's got 70% resistance. What are you doing?
Hold fast.
You're kidding me. You bled him again? 70% resistance. I guess maybe the enemy's...
in our imperfections.
Maybe the enemy's ability is getting... Oh no, they've got the taunt at round start, which is gonna make it difficult to kill the altars and stuff. Maybe the enemy has some, you know, penetration of resistance. I wouldn't like that, were that the case. Full stop. Do want to stand fast. Do like bellowing. No one's got a crit token or a riposte token at the moment. They're not going to get riposte tokens. And they're not going to get crit tokens either with this buff from the altar. Who has the worst resistances
all
on our backline?
Are human.
Moms. Okay. I'm gonna defend Moms. The reason being because I know that Clarion Call from the Herald is gonna come out against both of our backliners. That said, it's coming out while blinded. Oh, sorry, it's not Clarion Call I was looking for, it's First Trumpet, whereas Clarion Call could go against any of our field, First Trumpet has to target the back two. It'd be interesting to try and pull one of you out of position, however, 5 to 9 damage is really difficult to turn down as well. Hey, we got 6 and 9 damage on 2 different targets. This is why I would have wanted to bellow. I would have had the opportunity to act before all of the enemies get their opportunity to act in this round. Like, I'm happy to have the ability to respond to them, sure. But I also would have liked to prevent their abilities. That could have been nice. How'd you bleed him? He's got 86% bleed resistance. How are you doing this? I hit people who have 20% resistance and fail constantly.
Why?
I'm gonna absolutely blind the target that is taunting.
Fiend's strength dwindles.
Both of the backliners need a little more damage. Oh no, the Herald's dead, great, and the altar's dead as well. Grand. 34 health there. And it doesn't even look like it's that much. Wild. Okay, and now I'll bellow to remove the crit token, as well as slow the enemies. Ooh. 11 health and no bleed for our Jester.
Agony by accumulation.
Yeah, these two guys are going to be standing up for a while. I should probably make sure they don't ruin my day. Woof. Huge amount of damage to myself in order to do almost nothing to the enemy there.
A simple variable. Easily resolved.
A critical zero heal. Gotta love those. Spend a bunch of resources to do less than nothing. Less than nothing because it still wastes the turn of the character. I've got to get some health back on this, our frontliner. Which I elect to do by striking the enemy combo, gaining 6 health. I really want to prevent these enemies from hitting, but they just mean striking through my blind constantly. And also, only bleeding the targets is even really connecting with them right now in terms of damage. Okay, I should use Lash's Gift. Gives a dodge token to the self as well as a crit token, removes all negative tokens also. Good god, that's so much bleeding. Yeah, no, it's not gonna be damage. It's not gonna be healing time for a little bit here, buddy. It's, damage time. Unfortunately, only if I roll the 6 damage exactly do I really do anything against this Evangelist. That would be putting it on the ground. I will roll Defender just because I don't want direct attacks against the Flagellant right now. I got damaged at the start of the turn by my DOT. Now I need to use Lash's Gift in order to remove it again. Thankfully, I do get to crit heal myself with 15. Dodge token. Hey, the dodge. What? How'd they hit me despite the dodge token? Because the dodge token didn't even get removed. Oh no, never mind. I had 2 dodge tokens, of course. I would have loved to heal the Flagellant.
Oh boy. Oh boy.
Thank you for using Nocturne's Commune. The one ability that guarantees that you are not going to have an impact on the rest of the fight at all. Definitely need to start trying to blind targets consistently and such. 40 health on the weird reconstruction. Gotta love that. A critical heal for 29 on our Barristan, and now I feel much more comfortable again. Yay. I like this feeling. I need to yell at you again. I'm gonna. We debuffed the one that is going to remain on the field. A hopeful interaction has given some resistance buffs. I don't really want to be damaging myself right now if I can avoid it. So I'm gonna endure some stress. Gonna try and heal that character. Gonna try and remove some stress from that character as well. And then I want to, honestly, remove more stress from that character.
Compassion. Quiet the howling mind.
As long as I bellow in time, I don't need to really worry about the enemy here. And I'm gonna give myself the opportunity to possibly blind them, making them even less necessary to be worried about. I'm gonna yell at you. No more crit token. You definitely need to start dealing damage, so I'm gonna use Milksoak Linen to remove your blindness, giving you the ability to punish the enemy directly. And now, the end is near. So I face the final curtain. A weakening curse. Nice. We got missed. That would have saved us if we weren't. I'm gonna remove even more stress. Gain back a little bit of health. Solid combo. Hex the enemies for vulnerability, which unfortunately won't connect as much as I'd like. And then punish once more. unfortunately blinding myself. The enemy is now down on death's door. They use Blood's Commune for one damage, and that's the final action they're ever going to get to take. That's not a hopeful thing, that's guaranteed.
Ooh, 48, big heal, thank you.
They endure the stress off of our frontliner. Have the wish that I could remove even more. Alas, without being able to, we'll fade the enemy to black. 87 torch, leaving that fight. Oh, but we gain 10 at the end. Wounding words. If a stained item is equipped, you get plus 50% damage, but the negative 33% max HP. And Dark Impulse unlocks the potential of Cultist Trinkets. So it gives you Blight Resist, but if you are blighted, you are stressed. We don't really have a direct damage dealer, like a big damage dealer in this party. Not anymore, at least. Let's take a moment to think. So, Fishmonger's Gloves. If a serrated item is equipped, which it is in the Crow's Feet, has the 1/3 chance to apply a bleed. Also, it is our bleed resistance piercing. The Greater Clotting Claw, however, doesn't actually seem essential. I'm going somewhere with this. If that doesn't need to be on Mr. Gibberish, then John would be more than comfortable halting Fate's Foreteller, gain on DOT resist, heal 20%. John, by default, has 50% Blight Resist. With the Clotting Claw, would have 86% Bleed Resist, which means that our Flagellant would constantly be healthy. That's not what we want, though. Dang. Yeah, oh boy. Is it not what we want? Let's have a look at Jazzy. So Jazzy's currently holding the Price of Pride. Price of Pride's pretty good. And the Befuddling Sundial. Which is also really good. I just really want Fate's Foreteller to get some use. I was trying to structure a whole party around it, and no one's really ever using it in any way. I'm doing it. You need to put the Clotting Claw on. Gibberish, what do you want? On entering death's door, please don't do that. On turn start, convert your negatives to positives if you have them. None of that looks actually particularly great for us. That's 50% damage. I mean, you know, maybe if I tried to get Moms to be a Abyssal Artillery damage dealer for our back line, I could theoretically see this. Maybe. So, Gibberish, why don't you just hold the true entropy for the moment? Moms, you drop the Fate's Foreteller, which then goes on John. Jazzy, do I really want to give you the extra health right now? I don't think I want to, because I want to give Jazzy the extra health so that Jazzy is then capable of healing more with the Befuddling Sundial and things of that ilk. I could use the Befuddling Sundial in the backline for Moms. But, of course, healing 10% of 25 versus 55 is considerably different. The Mortal Ward and Greater Gilded Mine both seem like really good things for John to be holding. It's just not in the position that John is currently standing are those things that want to be held. All right. I think that's about as good as we're going to get it at the moment. Let's move on. Although also... yeah, I'm going to get rid of the second stack of milk-soaked linen so that I can get some bandages, because I just need the bleeds to be a little less powerful. Just tiny, a little less powerful, because it was about to do 48 damage to Jazzy. There we go, we've cleared an Oblivion, and now we pick one up. This is actually ideal, because it's basically as though the path is empty. Which is to say, I picked up an Oblivion right before I clear it. Ooh, Mr. Gibberish. How fragile they appear before our solidarity. I knew you were a soloist, but apparently you know how to play well with others. Yikes. That's a different unit under the back there. Oh, ordered to volley. I don't like that at all. Bullseye Barret.
Upon closer inspection?
I've never seen you before. Oh, no! 100%, 200% extra movement resist. Okay, so I'm not going to be able to just pull you out of line, which was my trump card that I was holding in my back pocket. My ace in the hole, if you will.
An unavoidable end.
True entropy has forced people to attack Mr. Gibberish. What with the taunt token and all. Trying to guarantee that that's not just gonna kill him instantly and tries to hit a target that does have block seems pretty useful to me. Hey, at least the drone is dead next round. Managed to hit both DOTs on them. Ooh, what?
No time to falter.
What?
Analysis is the natural prelude to action.
Right, so you tried to choose the Jester as your chosen target there. You failed. Chose our frontliner instead, and then dealt a truly ridiculous amount of damage. If I don't follow up with a heal of some kind, I will feel quite silly about that. Never mind, I just bled myself for 4 more damage than I healed myself for. One more time. Great! With those two actions, I have managed to do nothing. Zero things. I have taken as much damage as I have healed. And now I'm on death's door. However, thankfully, I lose some stress as a result of that. Pop some bandages to try and keep you alive. And then, how can you be so deathless?
A little health impeccably timed.
All right, Archer down. I'm gonna pump the torch. And defend a low health target. The movement resist of Bullseye Barret is now lower. I just can't have you stand there and do another piercing bolt volley, so you need to get out of that position, which means I need to pull you out of it. Serrated bolt for only 3 damage against our front line. I'm sure it's some bleed, but otherwise quite good. Harvest them.
Straightforward and effective.
Pop a little bit of a Lasher's Gift to get off death's door.
In crisis, we can rely only upon each other.
Yes, I do want to do more damage to Bullseye Barrett. However, I also want that little bit of health if I can get it. Enemy's been blinded. They still manage to hit, true. However, they do it for only 4 damage. I healed 8 on our Flagellant, who then resisted the bleed. And then healed more from Fate's Foreteller. Finally, it happened. Woo! It's gonna be enough.
Collaboration confers advantage.
Gotta stand fast, make sure that... Excuse me? Oh, can't gain block for a single round. Never mind, standing fast, they're not good. Yeah, should try and give someone some health. What with this deathless? With this crit? Sure. I'm looking to blind the frontline target if possible. And it is. Oh, I didn't recognize that target had, oops. Wait, I'm not on death's door. It just said I was, but I healed at the start of my turn after the DOT. So hang on. Healing, wait, so I did get the 2 weak stacks. So on the enemies, healing occurs before DOT. On the allies, DOT first. I guess I am comparing regen to a trinket interaction, but still. How dare you? I'm just gonna guarantee that target's dead. I don't want to make your relationships worse. Everyone's on low health, though. True entropy keeps giving me speed. Much appreciated. Oh, these weird reconstructions are going pretty well, gotta say. I believe it is ideal there if I take another hit. And then we'll roll Defender on the other likely target. Yep, 3 damage Atrophic Cut is not worth.
Slow suffering begins.
Not worth at all worrying about. The corpse is also going to die as soon as they hit. Well, I say corpse. I am counting my chickens. I just know that that unit is going to die.
Cooperation is the key.
Nothing I can do this turn really changes anything for that character. Big crit heal, big crit heal, big crit heal.
Relief comes rarely in these times. Savor it.
I don't want to lose any more health, so sure, I'm going to take some stress away from a character on field. And then generate even more stress on myself.
The smallest variable can make all the difference.
I could have skipped turn there. Couldn't have moved, obviously. We can't move at all. Could have skipped turn there, and that would have only actually provided to me 2 stress. Without the 1 stress reduction on Mars I got.
Is it not?
No! What? No! I should have known that... Should have known that this is going to be an ambush. Academic space. I don't want to take out a Shambler. They gave me garbage last time I took them out. It was actually, like, really not useful at all for me. I'm so ill-prepared for a Shambler right now. Neutralizing powders on all of my characters. As well as the trinkets that we have. Oh, the enemy actually wouldn't be able to shuffle the party. That's actually pretty huge. legitimately kind of gigantic. Well, hang on. The enemy can't shuffle our party. Maybe I can do this. Nope. Nope. I'll definitely lose a character if I do it. Going the other way.
Our once familiar kingdom. A stranger to itself.
I'm not ready to stack more corpses in this wagon. Oh, as it turns out, this is a hero shrine. I'm never sad to see those. At least at the moment. I know at some point in the future, when I'm done, apparently, there will be no more. I won't have to worry. I want to see the end of the Flagellant story.
Chapter 4.
Oh, second last chapter, I mean.
Death's Door.
Oh, sick!
Her scythe promised numbing oblivion. A premature end to his sacred journey of sensation.
Okay, death has full resistances to everything, including death blows. Except for debuff, 10% resistance is there. So I have punish from the front line to the enemy's front two to apply two blight. Acid rain to the enemy's back two from our front. There's a headstone, which also has low movement resist. Interesting. More, in order to give myself the... an empty version of the pain token. Interesting. Or Lash's Kiss. I get to take two actions this round. I think more is probably the appropriate start. The Flagellant delights in pain, including his own. Oh, okay. Yeah, so the more buff, which isn't shown on here, is then resulting in me giving myself the pain buffs. And in fact, surely I want to deal more damage to myself because I'm about to heal it, so I get to acid rain the enemy, which weakened them. I don't want to remove a DOT unless it's, like, potent. Yeah, that DOT is never affecting us again. Making it hard to care. Oh! Okay, I think what's meant to happen here is I'm meant to allow myself to get stressed. I'm obviously not going to win this fight by default. I'm meant to allow myself to get stressed enough in order to become toxic. And then ward death off. However, I think I need to cast more next turn. You don't cast that on the turn that you're, about to end, right? Mural Shadow of Death, my resolve is tested and I'm toxic! Such a sweet suffering. Such bitter delight. Sepsis! Hang on. Skill I've never seen before. Oh, it's the thing! I legitimately thought this was removed. Giant blight, or bleed as it used to be, to the target, and then it gives ourselves a big heal. What about that? Sepsis. Huge heal. And that actually did manage to blight the target despite their 100% resist. Neat. Okay, definitely time to smash the rain, weaken the enemy. Ah, they resisted the weakness. However, they still got blighted. But, I'm gonna more if I get to act before the enemies. That'll give me the opportunity to pick up a fair few stacks of pain. Got to weaken the enemy in anticipation of that incoming damage. We've got a second stack of pain for even more health.
Your reputation is overstated, huh?
I mean, I don't think I'm in a dire enough position to really need to use Sepsis immediately right now, and there's only two usages. There we go. Over the course of the fight. That said, it does represent a huge amount of damage dealt to the enemy. I will endure this and live forever. Yes. Get him, Flagellant. I demand more pain. The death is a death's door. You're home, buddy. Go inside. Leave me alone. Sepsis can now target any position and ignores death blow. We even crit with the final blow. Death itself cannot claim the flagellant.
Gruesome delights. His power was enough to defy death herself.
Sepsis requires self HP to below 50%. Has only 3 usages over the course of an entire fight. Cooldown of 2. However, it heals the self for 35% and gives the target 4 light. It is an extremely impactful move. Whoa! Hang on! That's its default version. The Examinate version of it is different. So the damage is now variable. It requires the enemy to have blight. Okay. Heals the self to 45%. Deals 75% of the remaining blight on the target as damage, and then it removes the blight. After upgrade, it will have one more use, because currently it only has 2 on the default, as well as deal 100% of the damage. Interesting. Don't want to drop punish. Don't want to drop endure. Endure's also probably the most droppable right now, though. Oh, actually. But the thing is, I can't rely on using Sepsis to heal my own character back up to full health when Lash's gift, like, no one else puts DOT on targets. So Sepsis can't really target anyone right now. It's really unfortunate. It can target up to enemy line 3. Maybe, you know, it'd probably be pretty good for the boss fight. A point in which I'm only going to be trying to deal blight damage and on low health, trying to heal. Neutralizing powders. I don't really expect it. Well, I guess the enemies could try and blight us. Sure. I'm gonna try and get some stress relief out of these neutralizing powders. Hoping that they strike my flagellant. Oh, true entropy gave us a crit token. Hell yeah. Harvest. Got a bit of sky slappage.
On to the next.
Beautiful. Incredible opener. Alright, 1 target left on the field. Huge crit. Crit! Good lord. We just can't stop critting. Just gonna remove all of the corpses from the field so that we can get a little up close and personal with this last guy, which thunk. As we thunk you to death. Meager rewards, but meager risk. Now, after this, I wanted to go to the left. But do I still want to go to the left? Probably most appropriate to try and figure that out after this fight. Definitely going to want to try and reduce the loathing here. So Marms is going to force the other two to take the battle. It could be pretty tough. I've seen worse. Specifically the bullet guy that I let get an attack off. He wasn't going to get moved. He's not allowed to be moved. Speaking of can't move them, these enemies are sturdy. They got 25% more max HP, but they've also got a third more, 33% rather, more chance to resist movement. Yeah, they're really blind in this fight. It's mostly bleed. Oh yes, bleeds. I don't like that they can just do that. Makes a fight really intimidating. Hey, you actually managed to bleed both of the targets. Beautiful.
Cooperation is the key.
Yeah, sure, I could try and yell at the targets, but I'm instead going to try and reduce the amount of damage that's going to happen here. Sky slap. See, prevention of 10 damage, and I also got myself another Price of Pride. Which is to say, another...
In crisis, we can rely only upon each other.
Another block of upcoming damage, and the bleed also gave me another Price of Pride. Neat. As for my own actions on this field right now, I kind of want to bellow at the enemies. I miss them all.
Haste and carelessness. Hallmarks of the unprepared.
Please stop smiting my party. I can't even heal the flagellant. The flagellant's mad. I'm not going to be healing him. Hey, if you got to focus fire anyone, that's the target to focus fire.
This road cannot be walked alone.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Price of Pride, for even more defense. Desperately necessary.
Deadly all the same.
Moms is back on death's door, however, is hopeful. So... yeah, two times I've been given resistance buffs on Moms here in the back line, who has not really managed to resist anything so far. Crit heal. Oh! Heals the self for 19 without even a single bleed. Gotta love to see that. I am not low health enough to use Lash's gift, apparently. Which pretty hugely surprises me. I don't want to watch the Arbalest get another hit, but... also, the Arbalest isn't the next person to act. Without any ability to really heal another character on field, I feel like taking someone's stress. Or I could use Acid Rain to try and get myself lower on HP. I'm gonna do that. Okay, the Arbalest is now dead, finally. I'm gonna pump the torch. Should've pumped the torch a couple times in this fight. I hope it's enough. I don't have the no blocking ability, so I will actually stone fast, so I have the ability to take the atrophic cut here.
Subtraction, an invariable result.
I really would have loved the flagellant to go first before Barristan. That is to say, for John to go before Jazzy, because then I would have been able to endure and then remove four blight in a quite singular action. Bishop's already dead. So unless I really care about managing the enemy front line immediately, which I kind of do. Sure. I'm gonna try and blind that target. I'm gonna manage to blind that target.
The smallest variable can make all the difference.
Unfortunately, I resisted the gain of stress, which heavily reduces the impact of this actual attempted outcome. Full heal for the Jester. A little bit of bleed on the back end, but full heal nonetheless. Trophic cut does manage to miss. Oh, another big crit heal! Ridiculous, our HP values are so high! Pop a quick inspiring tune. Love it. Let's keep this stress reducing. So it's just at round start I've been constantly getting stressed from the befuddling as well as the nervous. It's just started to get away from us. Thankfully it shouldn't be difficult at all to manage. Let's heal some. Use the torch first, then heal some by attacking the enemy with a combo. Crush him.
There is comfort in company.
Solid dodge, buddy. I want to get another inspiring tune off before the end of this all.
Brows, unsteady stances. Exhaustion takes hold. A small reprieve from this carousel of horrors.
Okay, enemies on death's door, their DOT will kill them after I play my inspiring tune for the flagellant.
Mind.
Two units on three stress, all the rest of them on zero.
The past is gone. Let it die.
Yeah, that was a good fight. We got a lot of negative relationship interactions with one another there, though. Combine our stacks of usables here, giving us some more space, and you know what, I'm just gonna move on after that rather than trying to clear up all the rest of it as well. So I did want to go to Oblivion's Ingress, but yeah, it's a long path of just fights for a while. And there's that big guy too. Already got a trinket. Either I'm going to the Watchtower and then the Hero's Shrine. You know what? I'm legitimately terrified of this Ingress. Some part of my soul strongly feels that if I take that path, I die. Now, backline damage is not great. A lot of my trinkets are based, like, they're really, really good, but they're also so narrow. If they don't activate, I feel a bit like a wimp, but discretion, valor, etc., so on and so forth. Also, like, I've just lost a lot of runs recently. I don't want to lose another one. After all. I'm very glad that this wasn't wheel destruction, which I was quite terrified of running into. Everyone's got reasonable HP.
By some existential shock. The poor devils roam aimlessly amidst the trees.
Oh, there is an oasis near the end as well. That could be pretty impactful. You know what? Yeah, let's go with the Hero Shrine. Kaisha's cool too, but...
A rare opportunity. Let us advance unimpeded.
Exactly. We don't have that many opportunities to finish off a character. And given how versatile the Flagellant has been for me, and can be in general, I think having the Flagellant with all of their abilities unlocked sounds like a great idea.
Every rapturous lash drags me further from her grasp.
Trying to give each of the characters a little bit of a voice.
Behold the man.
Behold the man. Once more he wandered, ravenous for fresh suffering, and delighting in its novelty and excess. Offering himself to blade and talon alike, he became an icon writ in flesh. A living prayer to whatever gods would turn an ear. Undying, he savored his delicious declension. An eternity of pain and wrath. Heaven on earth.
Incredible. Resolved. Acceptance is a journey. We get plus one mastery and undying. From any position to any position. Has a cooldown of 1, 10% damage to the self. However, the target gets regen. And necrosis. So from the two middle... From the two middle positions, it targets all of the enemies. However, it requires that they have blight. Has a cooldown of 1, and then it heals the self of 5. Interesting. I think they might tell us a lot more about what those abilities are on upgrade. About the, you know, the utility of them, what they intend to do. Undying. So after upgrade, undying gives 5 regen. 5 regen is so much bigger than 3 regen. 3 regen is 3 health, 2 health, 1 health, done. 5 regen is that plus 9. You know, the 5 and the 4. I mean, that's really good. Necrosis upgrades damage. What? That confuses me a lot. I mean, you know, if it targets all enemies, it is difficult to give it a really, really good upgrade. Because it'll be inflicting that against all enemies constantly, and you'll have to deal with that in your balance, but... I guess I am assuming that it only hits the people that have blight on them. Maybe it only requires one of the enemies to have blight, and then it can hit all of them, which would be pretty sick. Do I want to try and kill? Or do I want to try and pull someone out of position to ruin their move? I'm going to kill. Very high damage output. It's legitimately quite likely to kill.
My backline. It did nothing.
So Village of Crackshot's already dead, but I'll still roll a harvest because it's still better than Slice Off right now.
We can rely only upon each other.
Keep that torch high. Bellowing at the enemies, give myself some time. Make it easier to take out the Crackshot before the Crackshot gets another ability. No, I rolled a fender here. The enemy's front line are just going to continue doing low blows and finishing shots and things like that, and I would prefer if they did that against, you know, very little HP. Sky Slap. It's also stress recovery on John as well, so particularly handy in that fashion. I'm going to use Stand Fast, remove the combo target from myself, and give myself more block. Get him. Absolutely get him.
Master stroke.
Legitimately giant damage, and just enough in fact to put the enemy not even on death's door. There is no death's door for this enemy. To death this enemy.
Stupendous.
Guaranteed crit. Thank you, True Entropy.
Oh no, you did a little bit of damage to me. Oh no, I'm really hurt.
I'm gonna use Marms to slap the sky again, because it gives some stress recovery to John, and we are already in pretty severe control of this fight. I'm just going to guarantee the end of the fight.
Is a lesson learned.
I did want to set up a recovery turn there, but unfortunately, all of my DOTs failed to connect with the enemy. Would have needed the front one to die slowly there. But he's looking pretty good right now. Oh, hang on. I think I can actually... Never mind. I thought I had some more torches that I needed to throw onto Jazzy there.
Time to see if we can help him out. Desperate few.
I can't lower my torch that much, though. A wagon item for only 5. Seems good to me. Ooh, but food. What about food, though? Like, stale bread's pretty good, but what if this guy has some apples? Legitimately, what if he had some apples? I mean, like, the apples would be, you know, resistances as well. I'm gonna take it.
It's garbage.
Some slime mold as well as some bread. I know that no one's gonna eat two stacks of food when I get to the next inn, which means that because I know the next inn is the last inn, I can throw away the slime mold. I already have enough to feed all 4.
Today's oversight is tomorrow's regret.
Mm. 100% armor does give us the ability to start combats with armor. Oh, if I go forward directly to the academic study, I guarantee that I hit my loathing trigger. Don't want that. Same with the left, actually. I have to go to the oasis, no choice. Assuming I don't want to overload our loathing, there's no choice. I do like having heuristics like that that I can, you know, simplify things to in complex games like this, especially while I'm learning. They may not necessarily be robust and true. but they help me navigate the game for a long enough period of time that then I start to discover and learn and experience what is,
a refreshing commune,
instead, robust and true.
Unburdens the mind.
An oasis. I mean, oh look, the flask has run dry. Get him,
scavenge what you can, and be off once more.
This gibberish picks up 3 healing spring waters for us, which are especially good.
Analysis is invaluable until it becomes an excuse for inaction.
Yeah, I'm gonna need John to be able to attack when John wants to attack. So instead, I'm gonna give the neutralizing powders to Moms in the back line. So we're full on items at the moment, so I should throw something quickly. Never going to the Fater again at this point, obviously. Ablated powders, I don't think seem appropriate. I've only ever seen the enemy that I suspect I'm going to see again once, so I don't remember everything about them. Oh no, we didn't get stimulants there because we'd run over some stuff. Oof.
Yeah, it's them.
A parody of human
Hang
outline.
On, I'm finding a notepad.
It must be destroyed.
Obviously the altar needs tonight first. But I need to learn about this, because this is going to be a deadlock for a lot of runs, I can only guess.
And you will discover its weaknesses.
Okay, so Exaltation targets all of us, just high damage, one can assume. Prelude targets one. They do give DOT, but only with Prelude.
Let us take a closer look at the thing, as repulsive as it is.
Healer of Sacrifice. Sacrifice an ally in order to gain all of those. Are you gonna do that like immediately? Huge. I managed to hit a big blind on the character for a long time. Unfortunately, they are regenerating. Bleeding the character at the moment doesn't make any kind of sense, as much as I would love to. I wanted to blind the character. 50% chance of preventing them from getting off their next action, which I think is still going to be pretty relevant. So Prelude was obviously the setup to something, one can only assume. I'm going to roll Defender in order to give myself more defense. Maybe I want to go for Stand Fast. Ooh, remove the combo token from the cell. Hell yeah. I forgot that it has that utility. There's another Prelude and it gets missed. Interesting. The altar has very low movement resist. I'm going to use Neutralizing Powders to try and give Blight Resist to our frontline target. I'm going to use Demon's Pull to try and pull the altar out of position. We do manage to. It's going to get... No, it gets to act at the start of the round! I thought it was the enemy Exemplar acting there and I went... Oh no, you got 2 taunts on the enemy Exemplar! How dare you! I'm going to yell at the enemies now, because that will allow me to hit both of you. One stack of the taunt goes down, and we also get a debuff on the enemy. Neat.
A slow dissection. An unavoidable end.
I don't feel it makes any kind of sense to me to ignore the altar while it's available to attack. Lowest damage possible. And then it kills the altar. I was worried about that.
Let us hope to finish this quickly.
So it gives me that much time to kill the altar or suffer. Also, I just bellowed last round. No, my cooldown's on, so I don't even have the ability to get through the enemy's riposte here. All right. I'm gonna weaken the enemy. Combat tokens well. Use Rapturous Beauty damage to hit our backline and front line. Some horror, some stress, some vulnerability for the very back. Look, I do want to just blind the target every available opportunity. And people are gonna have to attack them. Good dodge. Vulnerability hex, maybe. I can't get attacked back while I'm vulnerable. It's too likely that basically just kills us. Prelude gets rolled on our back line. 15 damage as well as the blight. Deeply unfortunate. Is that you on death's door already as well? Yes, it is, unless I heal you, so I'm going to elect to do that. Oh, but I'm fine with you going on death's door, right? Hang on, moms. On death's door, you get a crit token. Actually, it's probably better to let moms go down to death's door here. And then moms will have the ability to crit themselves with a heal. But they also have a combo token on them. Probably means they're about to get targeted again. Giving it 9 extra health probably doesn't save you, though. This is all compared to the fact that hitting the enemy here is high damage. It forces the exemplar to strike back against the target that can kind of take it. And it's also basically guaranteed to blight.
The fiend's strength dwindles.
Oh, second prelude. Solid DOT resists. Love to see that. And heal Jazzy, remove some of your stress, and then roll Defender. Man, we've done like 9 damage to you. The enemy did have regen on them for a significant period of time here, so I don't feel so bad about the position we're in, I just don't like it. Especially while the Jester is just trying to blind the enemy to neutralize one of their attacks per round, I really feel it's appropriate to do damage with the Flagellant. Oh wow. This isn't good. 40% resist on debuffs? Maybe I'm giving up too much of my damage by not harvesting. Yet a 7% resist? How? How'd you do that? 11 health to the self with weird reconstruction in our back line.
The fall.
Okay, so that was against a combo target, did a huge amount of damage, and blinded them. Oh no. Uh-oh. Oh no, that was I gave you a second charge of worship, which I believe now means you're gonna be able to do another ability that might just be one of these modified. I'm gonna hold on to Bello in case it's crit and riposte set up. Ah, the fall from the enemy cannot target our backline. Interesting. So this combo makes, or is safe on Marms right now. As for what I can really do against the enemy, not much. Some health and stress heal to our flagellant. I'm taking too long on this. I'm going to defend the flagellant. Hilarious. What? Oh, no. Enemy can summon allies? Also, please, Mr. Gibberish, don't die right now. You've got a death blow resistance of 83. I really need you not to die. I'm gonna throw the crow's feet at enemies in order to remove the dodge of the cherub. I'd love to do a lot more than that, but right now, it's the best I can do. There's your confession. Puts horror on my jester. That's more than okay by me. You can use mineral-rich spring water in order to get the death's door away from our character. Exemplar is going to get an action. Unfortunately, soon. Yes, that means Jazzy should probably retarget. Making the cherub really hard to remove. Stand fast in response to that soon, which is nice. Moms, you really do need to heal someone. Give the flagellant all of their health, why don't you? That's a quick setup and follow through. I don't like that. Again, I'm gonna remove the dodge token from the enemy backline. Cost my crit token, though. I think I just have to risk Jazzy freaking out. Roll a harvest here. The harvest doesn't look like it's doing super well, but consider the alternative, which is I'd be dead. You know, I'm not going to do the self-heal here. I'm going to Sky Slap. 8 damage on the enemy backline. I don't really have the ability to
access the enemy backline that often.
Jazzy is tested and is resolute! This unit needs me. I must press on. Let's first off heal Jazzy off of Death's Door with the mineral-rich spring. That's entirely unnecessary. I'm gonna bellow at the enemy, removing your ability to riposte and debuffing you significantly. Ah, never mind. I did actually need to heal on the previous turn because my HP is not low enough on John. No! Oh, no! Please don't lose Moms off the back of that mistake. Exaltation. Summons another unit.
An interminable conflict.
Oh my god, this fight. Oh. This is the boss fight. Got resisted on another 7% roll there? I'm gonna try and make that guy deathless in the back line. Excellent, seems to have worked. A critical reconstruction of the self takes us all the way back up to a reasonable amount of HP on the field. Love it.
Suffering begins.
I feel like I should wait until I have a combo on Jazzy before I try and stand fast again. I'm gonna attempt to defend Mr. Gibberish here. There's the prelude, and then the follow-up fall. Uh-huh. We resisted all of the stress from that and only took 25% of the damage. Oh, baby. Sick. Here's a great opportunity finally to harvest. We guarantee a crit and also manage to bleed for 5 turns. I'll remove John's blindness before attempting to attack here. We also managed to crit the exemplar there. Great, 5 turns of bleeding for 5.
Relief comes rarely in these times.
Oh my god, the bleed resist trinket! Oh, this is... the combo is so good! Stand fast. Remove that combo target from the cell. Price of pride. There we go. Resist the bleed. Resist the bleed. Dang. Didn't resist the bleed there, unfortunately. Stop it. The regen you give to yourself every time you do that sucks. Jax, that was a lot of damage. And you immediately summoned. So you can't stop the summons, is what I'm seeing. You just need to try and kill the exemplar and survive the summon. Also, unless you can kill the summon basically instantly, it's almost not worth targeting, ever! I was really not expecting to get hit back directly like that. Definitely gotta get you up there, Thor. Rapturous beauty has struck our back line. Boy, huge blight on me. I want to defend a target, but I need to prevent the riposte. Looks like linen. Do extra blight to the target as well because I'm on low HP.
A slow dissection. An unavoidable end.
So I can heal 20% and gain 2 health with this pass here, which we'll have to do.
Is no time to falter.
Prelude has visited upon us another death's door, the altar of obsession, and god damn it! 30 extra health given to the target. I got one off Death's Door right before they got fallen. Now I have multiple units on Death's Door. Yay. I lash his gift, and then I immediately go back down to Death's Door at the start of the next turn. ...84% Deathblow resist. I'm gonna try. Didn't kill me. Critical heal for 11. Resist a bleed? Nope, didn't resist a bleed, unfortunately. Prelude sets up the death of our... Jester again, who we worked so hard to keep alive. Thankfully, they are still alive, technically, at the moment. Oh my god, really? Yeah, there's the Pillar of Sacrifice. The enemy just has regen at all times, and the regen is so much stronger than I am. I'm gonna bellow at you to remove your repost. And heck, I'm gonna blight you. Get myself back down to Death's Door in a way I really didn't want to do. That's why.
An unforeseen complication.
Mr. Girish's resolve is tested, and they melt down. That's okay. It's right before they probably die. Another altar! I give. Almost none of my moves make actual sense to try and do. Defend the Jester, who is probably dead. Oh, not yet. We heal and bleed the Jester, who then goes back down to Death's Door at the start of that turn. Yeah. Try and bleed the enemy. We got a 7% resist from them last time, which was really bad, unfortunately, because the enemy has regen, and my biggest damage dealer is dead, which means the enemy is just getting further and further and further away from my ability to deal damage and kill them.
Fellowship.
Grab you back off Death's Door. You resisted a bleed. Good to see. I can't kill the altar, and I can't out-damage the heals that it gives to the exemplar right now. The fact that it healed, like, pulled two altars for its last two summons here... maybe all that can be written about us. Remove a vulnerability from a target by rolling a... bolster there?
Agony by accumulation.
Barristan, you gonna... Sorry, Jazzy? Dang, I was really hoping for a second resolute resolve there. Boy. Alright. Kidding me? Oh! Mr. Gibberish has health again. Jazzy is still about as weak as is possible. Let's roll the defender on Moms. There's the Pillar of Sacrifice. There's the huge regen. Another 18 health to the enemy. Yeah. I have to allow them to hit me back there because I have to be able to bleed the enemy, otherwise I'm not gonna kill them. Never mind, I failed to bleed the enemy there. 7% chance again for them to resist that. And there's another altar, baby! Woo! We're dead! Literally, like, it's over. I can't overwhelm that with all of my units on Death's Door and my healer gone.
Victory supposes strategy.
Oh! Victory supposes strategy. The announcer is here to tell me.
Malaise, measured and steady.
I guess I'll consider doing some strategy next time. My bad. get Jazzy back up. Sorry, Mr. Gibberish back up, rather. How? I don't know how this enemy has resisted so many bleeds. Ah. I used it. Never mind, I'm not rolling 7% chance resists. I used my crow's foot, the serrated item that was guaranteeing the lower bleed resist from the enemies. Weird reconstruction on self for one. That's enough to bring you back to life, baby. Ooh, love that regen. Crush the enemy for some HP. Yes, that makes sense. Got a lot of stress resist in this body.
A petty hindrance.
I do kind of want the enemy to kill me right now, and that's just because, like, there we go. Because I can see the inevitability already on board, and I'm just watching myself die for a really long period of time. It would be remarkable to bring it back from that position, but that was never going to happen. All right. We're just casually on death's door. It's all good. All right. You can do it by yourself, right, Mr. Gibberish? No.
That makes sense.
I listened to you all. I dared to hope. I'm so sorry that we accidentally convinced you to hope.
Well done.
Hey, I do know now that bellow is very important in this chapter. The ability to remove that equation,
unfavorably rounded down.
The ability to remove that double stack of riposts really, really gives us a good position in that fight.
The next road just a little easier.
And we grab for ourselves 60 candles as well. Fair enough. That should make our next run much more successful. For the moment, though, my name's Renacity, the name of the game. Well, it's been Darkest Dungeon, and that was the exemplar. Hopefully you all have been enjoying yourselves, or it's a top list. A playlist in the top left. YouTube recommendations down below, and streaming past, and the names of the people so generously supporting the Republic on patreon.com/RhapsodyPlays, out or above the thank tier. And a special thanks this episode to John. Hopefully you all have been enjoying yourselves, and hopefully see you all